Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI slider control. Using the .NET MAUI slider, you can select a value within a range by sliding a thumb along a track. Now, I'll be showing you how easy it is to add the slider control to the .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to bind value, set minimum and maximum values with intervals, labels, tooltips, ticks, dividers, and change the orientation. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI slider into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI sliders package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Once the package is installed, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the Syncfusion MAUI sliders namespace. Now, initialize the slider control by adding the SF slider tag. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native Vue API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file, add the register license method, and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, refer to the description below. Then press the F5 key to run this application. See, the default slider is rendered, and you can drag the thumb to any point. All right, let's see how to enable the labels on the slider. To do that, I enable the Show Labels property. Look here, slider renders with labels. By default, the minimum value of the slider is 0, and the maximum value is 1. And the interval is calculated based on the screen size, minimum and maximum value. Here the interval is 0.1. Suppose you want to customize the track range and intervals in the slider, you can use properties such as minimum, maximum, and value, among others. For example, if you want to set the range of the slider from 1 to 10 with an interval of 1, just set the minimum value to 1, the maximum value to 10, and the interval to 1. The current value of the slider can be represented by the value property, which can be set to any number within the range of the slider. I'll set the value to 5. Check now, the track in the slider is customized based on provided values. Currently selected value is 5 and a slider thumb is drawn corresponding to this value. In case you want to apply formats for slider labels, you can use the number format property and set its value to currency format. And here, the currency format is applied to the labels. Next, I will show you how to enable the tick lines for the slider. To do that, I enable the showTicks property in the slider. Check now, major tick line is shown in the slider track. You can also add the minor ticks between major ticks. To do that, I add the minor ticks per interval property and set its value to 1. Here, the minor ticks are shown in between the major ticks. Next, I will show you how to divide the sliders using shapes to represent the major interval points. To do that, I enable the showDividers property. Look now, the divider is shown for major interval points. Here I can also customize the active and inactive radius of the divider so that it can be visible clearly. To do that, I add a divider style property. Then, define the slider divider style with the active radius property to 3 and inactive radius to 7. See, the radius of the divider is increased based on the provided values. By default, the slider's highest value is shown on the right and the lowest value on the left. Suppose you want to inverse the slider, then simply enable the isInversed property. The slider renders with the highest value on the left side and lower values on the right side. Apart from these options, you also have another option to indicate the current selection of the value during interaction using a tooltip. To do that, I add the tooltip property and include the slider tooltip. Check now, a tooltip is shown for the currently selected value. Finally, I will show you how to select track values discretely. To do that, I include the step size property and set its value to 2. And now, the values are selected discretely. Notice here, slider is rendered with a horizontal orientation by default. I can also show the slider in vertical orientation. To do that, I include the orientation property and set its value to vertical. See, the slider rendered with vertical orientation. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have showed you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion MAUI slider control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.